Is it recording?
I'm recording now.
Okay. So, Alan, I went to Hawaii for the weekend, all right? Oh, you're going to need to put your headphones around
They won't stretch that far.
Well, then film it from there, you muppet.
Oh, okay.
Just put your headphones around the thing so we can hear what Alan says.
But okay.
Turn the camera on me.
I'm so rubbish.
Is that your headphone there? Okay. Say something, Alan.
Excuse me!
Yeah, but say something with your mouth near the phone.
My mouth is near the phone, Iain.
Then how's it suddenly got a lot quieter?
No, I can hear it because I've got you on loudspeaker.
Well, don't put me on loudspeaker. I hate loudspeaker.
Okay, you're off loudspeaker
Thank you.
Now.
So I went to Hawaii for the weekend.
Yeah?
And I stopped over at LA Airport, LAX, for 3.5 hours. And I've got to say, LA Airport is the most boring, worst airport in the world, okay? So I'm there, I'm reading my Charlie Brooker, I'm having a Burger King, I'm going to go for a Jimmy Riddle. Walking towards the toilets, Alan, who did I see?
Who?
I'll tell you exactly who I saw. It was none other than Al Jardine, the rhythm guitarist from the Beach Boys.
Ooh.
Yeah, so I see Al Jardine. He's one of the lesser Beach Boys, but he's still a Beach Boy, right? So I'm thinking, oh, I want to shake hands with him, but he's just seen me blowing my nose, so I can't do that. So I went to the toilet, okay, and I had a wee, and I was quite nervous, and I was like, I'm going to speak to Al Jardine. And I was trying to think of, I was looking on my phone, trying to find out what the obscure song was that he wrote for the Surf's Up album in 1972, so I'd be able to go in and say something. I come out of the toilet, Alan, do you know what?
What?
He'd gone.
Oh dear.
Gutted. Oh dear indeed. Gutted. So I started looking around. Then I saw him again. This time he was with his wife. And I'm getting nervous. And I love the Beach Boys. I'm getting sweaty and I'm a little bit nervous. And then he starts going down an escalator. And I think, man, I've got to go and do this. I've got to go and speak to a Beach Boy. So he's going down the escalator. He gets to the bottom of the escalator. I see him and I call his name, Mr. Jardine. Now, I'm about to act for the video camera. What happened, Alan? And I will try and describe it as best I can. You need to be able to see the side of my face. So okay. I said, Mr. Jardine. And he kind of, like, looked down, put his hands on his side, sighed, as if to say, what does this dick want? And then turned around and went, oh, yes, can I help you? And I just thought I was crushed inside, Alan, because he obviously didn't want to talk to me. So I'm bumbling along and I go, well, sir, I actually called Al Jardine, sir. Well, sir, I just want to say I'm really a big fan and I don't want to spoil your day or anything, so I'll be off. And he went, oh, okay, nice one, thanks. And I'm thinking, what a dick! Part of me's thinking, what a dick. Part of me's thinking I really want to touch myself because I've just met a Beach Boy, even if he was a bit rude to me. I did genuinely think that. And so the question on everyone's lips is, Alan, have you ever been snubbed or made to feel small by a celebrity?
Well, I have actually, by a sports person.
Oh, yeah. Okay, who was that?
Tony McCoy.
Who?
A horse racing jockey.
Right, okay. And what happened?
I said, Mr. McCoy, can I have your autograph, please, sir? And he just ignored me and just walked straight on.
Oh, man. And also, it's someone... You think someone like that, like Al Jardine. Al Jardine has not been recognised for 35 years. He should be grateful. He should be grateful that I'm going up to him and I'm just saying, didn't ask for a photo, didn't ask for an autograph, which is my right as a fan, didn't ask for a handshake, didn't do anything. He made me feel yay small, Alan, yay small.
Oh dear.
Oh dear indeed. Well, Alan.
What other topic have we got?
Oh, you're not buying those ones?
Well,
okay. Well, later.
Let's see what third topic we got.
Okay, well, have you seen the television programme Live from Studio 5?
Yes, I have. We've been white, it's here, white. Melinda Lovely's messenger, and Kate, I didn't win the Apprentice roles.
That's the show. Isn't it the greatest show on television?
Yeah.
It's brilliant. Because I like watching three vacuous people with the whitest teeth I've ever... I've never seen such white teeth. Have you?
I was watching it.
It's the whitest teeth in the world. Just not really having any opinions on anything. I find that quite exciting.
I mean, the one show's got nothing on now.
The one show's got nothing. It turns out the higher the number in the show, the better the show. So the Live from Studio 5 is 5 times better than the one show.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not really grabbing you, these topics, are they?
Well, what's the question relating to Live from Studio 5?
Well, that's the thing. There isn't really a question for it. It's just, you know, Isn't it a good show? Do you like the show? Isn't it a good...
I can think of something far, far better, which I watched for the first time tonight.
Oh, in that case, I'd like to hear that, yeah.
Well, it's a programme on BBC3 called Don't Tell the Bride.
Oh, is that where the man gets to do the wedding?
Yep.
That show's brilliant, man! It's almost as good as Four Weddings.
I was laughing, I was in stitches.
Did you touch yourself?
No, I didn't.
Oh, you should have done.
No, because my sides were splitting.
Your sides were splitting, so you couldn't touch yourself. Alan, I've got to go. Thank you for that, fella.
Okay.
Good to know you're alive.
Well, I will try and make the effort to try and call Wednesdays and Thursdays.
Don't put yourself out too much, mate. Well, you're Alan Cavett there, ladies and gentlemen. For the person who's just texted in saying, shut that up and play some bloody music, here's a song for you. Hope you enjoy. Def Leppard, yeah.
Bye.